to the second channel, man, and the beat from the intro is provided by Mike on the Beat. There's a link in the description below that's going to take you to downloadpads.com. From there, you can find this particular beat tape because I'm live streaming it, and get the contact information via Twitter, and if you holler at me to get some beats, tell them I sent you. But anyway, on to today's reply. Today's reply is to that young thug, and I guess you could say Birdman, that Givenchy. And honestly, this song wasn't all that bad, especially in comparison to the pure trash that Young Thug puts out. Like, for the most part, Young Thug's music, you just can't listen to it at all. But this right here, you can actually play in the background or some shit. I mean, the production wasn't all that bad, but I really just find it funny. Like, first, was that Birdman spitting a verse in the beginning? I mean, some may think that that was like a long intro or some shit, but when has Birdman actually rhymed? Like, I think he was actually spitting there. And then you look at the video like, damn, Young Thug, is those spandex tight jeans? But the main thing I want to talk about here is how obvious it is that Young Thug is just Lil Wayne's replacement. Hence one of the reasons why I be telling people all the time, damn that loyalty to people who's not loyal to you, especially these record labels and such, man. Cause I guess Lil Wayne thought that Birdman was just gonna stay loyal to him forever, especially when the album start to slide. Nah, bruh. He instantly found his replacement. I mean, think about it. When was the last time Lil Wayne had a video like this? And it's all the more obvious when Young Thug says stupid shit like, oh, I'ma do the Carter 6 through 10. Don't you see that, okay, you were Brett Favre, and now Green Bay is trying to bring in what they perceive to be Aaron Rodgers? When, let's keep it 100, Young Thug is like the Ryan Leaf of all fucking new artists. But overall, I would say this track is worth like one listen, and then you just let it go from there. But anyway, on to Ask, Download Pass. And Danny asks, you could say that football and basketball, they were all once all white. And what he's saying this to is pretty much in response to how hip-hop and R&B is pretty much becoming all white these days. Now, there's a huge difference here that you're missing, in which the difference is a fucking savage takeover to proper integration. Yes, sports were all white, but that was because they kept us the fuck out. Why we got integrated in is because we were that fucking good. But you cannot deny that slavery bred us to be excellent fucking athletes. That's just real fucking talk. But just based off of the merit of skills, we were going to get put on in the fucking game. Now that's the difference of what's going on in hip-hop right now. Because even though we created hip-hop, we accepted other races as long as they were skilled. Eminem got accepted for his second fucking album into the game. Like, for real, for real. That was really before the agenda took hold. I mean, you look back at the Beastie Boys and shit, man, they were still accepted, while the terrible rappers like Vanilla Ice and all of that shit, they got shitted on as they should. Now today, due to this agenda and savage fucking takeover, they pretty much ensuring that the terrible white rappers have a opportunity here because they only promote terrible black artists. But when they get themselves a good white rapper, he becomes the face of the shit. And it's going to continue to be like that till it gets to the point where you can't get promotional dollars for being black in hip-hop. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow me at Twitter up there, and you can go to downloadpads.com, that's down there, to read today's article.